Hello everyone! Have you ever wondered how did viruses come about in the first place? Well, good news! Because today, I'll be telling you more about the origin of viruses. To tell you more about the origin of viruses, I'll share with you three main scientific theories that seek to explain how viruses have evolved from the past to the present. Before we move on into that, however, we first need to know a few simple facts about viruses. By definition, viruses are small infectious agents that replicate only inside the living cells of other organisms. They have an extremely simple cellular structure comprising of a capsid, nucleic acids, and a glycoprotein gelicode. While viruses have many other secondary structures, in addition to these three main structures, these three are the main structures. You can see here is a diagram of a typical animal virus. Inside lies the nucleic acid, which is enclosed by the capsid, and the surrounding things are spikes that allow it to hook on to other cells to infect them. Now, a virus has a basic replication cycle, which mainly consists of invading a host cell and then using the machinery of the host cell to carry out viral replication. More on this later. Now we can move on to the first hypothesis, the regressive hypothesis, which seeks to explain how viruses have evolved over time. As you can see here, the regressive hypothesis states that viruses were once smaller cells that parasitized larger cells. However, over time, the cells realized that their parasitism was so much more useful and dependent that they abandoned the genes required for them to survive outside a host cell. As a result, they evolved over time to become the viruses we know today that can only replicate inside host cells. Evidence for this seems to lie in the bacteria known as rickettsia. Although this is a bacteria, not a virus, its replication cycle is extremely similar to that of a virus. Let's take a look over here. As you can see here, this is the rickettsia bacteria. It infects a healthy cell, and then it takes over the cell's DNA and replaces it with its own. Following that, it uses its host machinery to form other more new bacteria cells. With that, it causes the cell to lyse, and the bacterial cells escape to infect other organisms. However, the main problem with this theory on how viruses have evolved from smaller cells that used to parasitize larger cells is that cellular parasites of today and viruses of today share almost no resemblance whatsoever. If this theory was true, then it would be logical to assume that cellular parasites would have some form of similarity to viruses today, given that this theory states that viruses have evolved from cellular parasites. As you can see for these two diagrams drawn, the cellular parasites comprises of many more complex organelles such as the Golgi body, the nucleus, and mitochondria, whereas a typical virus only consists of the three main structures that I mentioned earlier, such as the protein coat, nucleic acids, on the cellular origin hypothesis. The cellular origin hypothesis states that viruses evolve from bits and pieces of DNA and RNA, such as plasmids and transposons. Now, you may ask, what are plasmids and transposons exactly? Plasmids are pieces of naked DNA that can move between cells, and transposons are molecules of DNA that replicate and move around to different positions within the cell. In short, they consist of genetic material that have already been able to be mobile both within and outside the cell. Thus, the theory seems to have some credibility, as it seems likely that this genetic material is able to code for some of the very simple structures of a virus. However, the flaw within this theory is that it does not explain how virus structures have come to have such other complex structures beyond the three basic structures. As earlier mentioned, as you can see here, this animal virus has spikes. And this animal virus has a sheath which allows it to attach to other living cells. If the cellular origin hypothesis was true, viruses would not be able to have such complex structures, as the genetic material within plasmids and transposons is simply not enough to code for such complex structures. Thank you for listening to my video today. I hope you have gained more insight into how viruses have evolved into being. Although we do not have an exact answer yet, the future of science continues to progress, and hopefully one day we have an answer as to how these viruses have come to plague us. Thank you.